She's almost here, James.
Huh. You know what? I'm starting to think I like weddings already.
But it didn't even start.
So? Very interesting. Anybody else but me realize that this is filmed at the Tower of London?
I think I see Prince Harry.
Me too.
But where's the bride?
She's coming, James.
Look at that. I think this is where the car the bride gets off.
Cute little flower girls.
They're doing a great job so far.
I think the last car. Oh, never mind.
Difficulty.
Yeah, we could have decorated something very, you know, wedding-like. We missed the wedding because we have to work.
I know. Thank God for the, you know, the camera.
I think this is the car where the bride gets out.
I think I see her.
Look at that old-time black car.
Hey, you!
But it can't talk.
I wish it would.
That looks like the Tower of London to me. I visited London once.
I remember that, Gorn. That was many years ago.
Oh, one of them said congratulations.
What a good remark. And very splendid remark.
Hey, you two. Oh. Henry, where'd you come from?
Well, I just came to see what you two are doing.
Oh, I see you're watching the wedding.
And the bride's coming out. You're just in time, Henry.
Congratulations.
Right. How can you tell she's a bride?
Because the veil and the white wedding dress?
You know, I remember wedding dresses back in our day. They were more special, more splendid. Those were the days, James. Those were the days.
And look, these guys are carrying the veil.
She's so lucky.
Yeah. Ain't that the truth?
I think that's the priest waiting.
Oh my, this is so exciting. I can't believe we're watching a wedding. Oh, I cannot wait.
I want to see her walk down the aisle.
She will.
What do you think a wedding is for?
Here comes the music.
I think I see the bride walking down the aisle. She's so beautiful. Hey, what are you guys doing?
You didn't tell me you were watching the wedding. I want to watch too. It's just started, Thomas.
I didn't see you there, little Thomas. I think we might want to dim down the lights.
Good idea.
That's better.
Doing better?
What do you mean better? I mean, doing good. Hey guys, I see you're watching the wedding of Prince Harry and Meghan Markle.
Yes, we are.
Bet you got more room for more engines.
Who is this crowd?
Diggity dog.
Can we watch too?
Oh, sure.
What a peaceful spot. Back to my speech. Did you guys finish your jobs?
Of course we did.
So come here and kind enough to let us watch this.
Here it comes.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you. God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them.
What's that noise? I don't know.
In the presence
we
of God,
want.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we have come together to witness the marriage of Henry, Charles, Albert, David, and Rachel Meagan, to pray for God's blessing on them, to share their joy, and to celebrate their love. in creation, through which husband and wife may know the grace of God. It is given that as man and woman grow together in love and trust, they shall be united.
I see you guys are watching a wedding.
Body and mind.
Stay, man.
As Christ is united with his bride, the church. The gift of marriage brings husband and wife together in the delight and tenderness of sexual union and joyful commitment to the end of their lives. It's given as the foundation of family life, in which children are born and nurtured, and in which each member of the family, in good times and in bad, may find strength, companionship, and comfort, and grow to maturity in love. Marriage is a way of life made holy by God.
I think there's kind of joy
of our Lord Jesus Christ with those celebrating a wedding at Cana in Galilee. Marriage is a sign of unity and loyalty, which all should uphold and honor. It enriches society and strengthens community. No one should enter into it lightly or selfishly, but reverently and responsibly in the sight of Almighty God. Harry and Meagan are now to enter this way of life. They will each give their consent to the other and make solemn vows. And in token of this, they will each give and receive a ring. Pray with them, that the Holy Spirit will guide and strengthen them, that they may fulfill God's purposes for the whole of their earthly life together.
There are more entrants coming.
First, I am required to ask anyone present who knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it now. Harry and Meagan, the vows you are about to take are to be made in the presence of God, who is judge of all and knows all the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you knows a reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it now. Harry, and forsaking all other, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live.
I will.
Oh my.
Meagan, will you take Harry to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
And will you, the families and friends of Harry and Meagan, support and uphold them in their marriage now and in the years to come?
Yep, we will.
As we stand, let us pray for Harry and Meagan. God, our Father, from the beginning you have blessed creation with abundant life. Pour out your blessings upon Harry and Meagan, that they may be joined in mutual love and companionship, in holiness and commitment to each other. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Thank you.
say you don't mind.
I wish I could have got my first time talking with me. He would love it. He would love it.
Amen.
From the Song of Solomon in the Bible. Set me as a seal upon your heart, as a seal upon your arm. Love is as strong as death, passion fierce as the grave. Its flashes are flashes of fire, a raging flame. Many waters cannot quench love. Neither can floods drown it out. The late Dr. Martin Luther King once said, and I quote,
"Sorry.
We must discover the power of love, the redemptive power of love. And when we do that, we will make of this old world a new world. For love. Love is the only way."
Amen to that.
There's power in love. Don't underestimate it. Don't even over-sentimentalize it.
Yeah.
There's power. Power in love.
Yep.
If you don't believe me, think about a time when you first fell in love. The whole world seem to center around you and your beloved. Well, there's power. Power in love. Not just in its romantic forms, but any form, any shape of love. There's a certain sense in which when you are loved and you know it, when someone cares for you and you know it, when you love and you show it, it actually feels right. There's something right about it. And there's a reason for it. The reason has to do with the source. We were made by a power of love. And our lives were meant and are meant to be lived in that love. That's why we are here. Ultimately, the source of love is God Himself. The source of all of our lives. An old medieval poem that says, "Where true love is found, God Himself is there." The New Testament says it this way: "Beloved, let us love one another, because love is of God, and those who love are born of God and know God. Those who do not love do not know God. Why? For God is love." There's power in love. There's power in love to help and heal when nothing else can. There's power in love to lift up and liberate when nothing else will. There's power in love to show us the way to live. Set me as a seal on your heart, a seal on your arm for love. As strong as death. But love is not only about a young couple. Now, the power of love is demonstrated by the fact that we're all here. Two young people fell in love, and we all showed up. But it's not just more and about a young couple who we rejoice with. It's more than that. Jesus of Nazareth, on one occasion, was asked by a lawyer to sum up the essence of the teachings of Moses. And he went back and reached back into the Hebrew scriptures to Deuteronomy.
Deuteronomy and Leviticus, and Jesus said, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, all your mind, and all your strength. This is the first and great commandment.
I'm starting to think these British people are Christians. I'm a Christian.
Shh. On these two, love of God and love of neighbor, hang all the law, all the prophets, everything that Moses wrote, everything in the holy prophets, everything in the scriptures, everything that God has been trying to tell the world. Love God. Love your neighbors. And while you're at it, love yourself. No. Someone once said that Jesus began the most revolutionary movement in all of human history. A movement grounded in the unconditional love of God for the world. And a movement mandating people to live that love. And in so doing, to change not only their lives, but the very life of the world itself. I'm talking about some power. Real power. Power to change the world. If you don't believe me, well, there were some old slaves in America's antebellum South who explained the dynamic power of love and why it has the power to transform. They explained it this way. They sang a spiritual, even in the midst of their captivity. It's one that says there is a balm in Gilead. A healing balm, something that can make things right. There is a balm in Gilead to make the wounded whole. There is a balm in Gilead to heal the sin-sick soul. And one of the stanzas actually explains why. They said, if you cannot preach like Peter, and you cannot pray like Paul, you just tell the love of Jesus how he died to save us all. Oh, that's the balm in Gilead. This way of love is the way of life. They got it. He died to save us all. He didn't die for anything he could get out of it. Jesus did not get an honorary doctorate for dying. He wasn't getting anything out of it. He gave up his life. He sacrificed his life for the good of others, for the good of the other, for the well-being of the world, for us. That's what love is. Love is not selfish and self-centered. Love can be sacrificial. And in so doing, becomes redemptive. And that way of unselfish, sacrificial, redemptive love changes lives. And it can change this world. If you don't believe me, just stop and think for a minute. Think and imagine. Well, think and imagine a world where love is the way. Imagine our homes and families when love is the way.
Yeah.
Imagine neighborhoods and communities where love is the way. Imagine governments and nations where love is the way. Imagine business and commerce when love is the way.
Thomas, what are you thinking? I just decided to skip this whole service and just go on to the vows. But the vows are already told. If only they were half sold, those on Sodor. But we are in Sodor.
kiss you, said Thomas.
Someone's coughing.
Can you get the hand out of here?
Sorry. Sorry, Oliver. It is all right, Mr. Cameraman.
If I can film the room,
I know. So nice of you to get the wall, Oliver.
I thought... never mind.
Seems like they already know.
But you didn't see him kiss.
Hey, Oliver. Come on, can you skip the second?
hands are so sticky. Just walk through a kiss on the balcony. Good idea. There you go, walking out of the aisle. I wonder how we got such a big crowd of vengeance all of a sudden. We just wanted to watch it with you guys. You're a brother. Going Scotland? I've seen the wedding. Wait, when? On May 19th, the day of the wedding. How? There. Someone show me a laptop. Woohoo! Congratulations! Congratulations to the Prince Harry and the American Mountain. Well, she isn't a market anymore. She's part of the royal family. Emma? Yeah, they kissed. We love you, Prince Harry. We love this couple. And they're going off in their royal carriage. Oh, they're just stepping down the stairs. I guess any woman won't lose their glass slipper. Yeah, good point. Hooray! Congratulations! There's the royal carriage.
Of all these people, I think all the
What were you going to say, James?
Well, what I was going to say is, Britain and America is coming together
a little bit more
than we expected.
And today,
they once fought in the Revolutionary War. That was a long, long time ago, before steam engines are even built. Way before we made our success and have all these engines.
That's right.
You said it.
Edward, are you crying?
No. I'm just sweating through my eyes.
Okay, that's gross.
Yes, I am crying.
Aren't we all glad most of us are part of the, once part of the British Railways?
Mm-hmm, I guess so.
Thank the Lord.
Long live Prince Harry!
Long live Prince Harry!
If only Cranky, the Naga Jenkins, and the miniature engines would have seen all this.
I'm sure they always see it. Their drivers. What I heard, the drivers are like showing them on their own devices.
That makes sense.
But I'm saying the British Railways,
we're glad to be part of our solar. We didn't get scrapped or anything.
Yeah.
That's better.
The congratulations!
And I guess there's a royal parade after all. After all this. Yeah.
My God. My face is amazing. Fuck.
You know, they could have just used a car. Or how about a steam engine? Good one.
Can't you believe it? They're married.
Ready to start a new life. You guys want to skip the parade?
We can just watch some of it.
Yeah. And there it is. The towers.
Interesting.
Hey lady, are you gonna get on that bus?
Hey Donnie, what will happen if another prince will marry one of the Scottish people?
I wouldn't be surprised.
Since most of the engines we knew around here are British.
But I'm American.
We know.
Oh.
Sorry I'm late.
Did I miss the whole ceremony?
Yes, you did.
But we're glad you're here now, Rosie.
I like that. Oh, yeah.
Thank you. And
time. Aren't you just glad they're married?
Heck yeah. It's gonna be one heck of a life for them.
I just remembered. Meagan was an actor.
Oh yeah, she was.
But will she still act?
No, according to the Wikipedia, she retired.
Oh, the identity.
Never mind, Gordon.
All you want to end is to just go now. Except for you, Rosie. You stay here.
I think I hear the classic cheering sound.
I can hear it too.
Oh, darn it.
Can I stay here?
Sir Ryan.
This must be one of the happiest days of their lives.
Except for McCarthy.
Their birthdays, of course.
Do you remember what their birthdays became then,
Thomas?
No.
Maybe we should look it up.
don't. Miss Dan Oliver, I thought you would never come.
Well, I just decided to stop by.
Just get all that. Good idea.
Annie, Clarabelle. Can you get to with Meagan?
Good Thomas.
Oh, love that.
And look, I think there's the Tower of Buckingham. It looks so.
Don't you think the flying scotsman made one of those trains?
I don't know. Have you contacted him?
What engines we don't use?
Phones don't pass.
Oh yeah.
You know, fellows, I once tried to get into it.
Oh, you are going to go out there.
I'm just gonna say it, boy.
What an adventure.
A 55-minute adventure.
Oh, yeah.
Let's get on there. Sure.
What are you doing, Thomas?
Being at the whole office.
Is there any way you can make it faster?
No, that's how you two get to Thomas.
Okay.
All these people.
I think I might take a while, really.
Okay, good night, Ryan.
Good night, Thomas. Good night, everyone.
Yes, I'm back of Donnie again. I gotta... taken early too.
Good night, blind specimen.
Good night, brother.
Good night, little brother.
Little brother.
Oh, I say.
Oh, good thing they left.
I'm going to bed. Got a whole day of work tomorrow.
Me too. So why? I had to sleep with Philip tonight.
See you on Boxing Day.
Goodbye, Thomas.
Ooh. Can we watch it again?
James, we just saw it. Maybe tomorrow.
Okay, guys, I'm taking a rest.
Oh, the video's over?
Yep.
What a great relationship.
When to Prince Harry again? Got engaged again?
November.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I got it taken. Tell me when Tom sees the world.
Maybe sometime in July?
I think so.
Yeah. I love weddings.
You know what? Me too.
Let's watch it again. James!
Okay, you win. Sure you don't mind?
Of course I won.
You're my best buddy, James.
Do you want to just get married?
No.
Okay.